in binary fish and in amoeba and budding in yeast and hydra with the help of prepared slide. Okay. Yes, good afternoon, ma'am. Can I write the practical from practical book? Yes, you can write it down. But all the points you have to write all the points properly. That's why I'm helping you to write it down. Okay. So I think in your revised syllabus from the biology portion, I have got this one only. I have to check once more, but I have got this one only. So here two type of the reproduction is there, that is binary fission and budding, and that can be shown by a prepared slides. Okay. So as we were reading that reproduction part, and this portion comes under that reproduction, that's why first I will complete that part. So as I can remember that we have completed the chapter from the textbook, right? Reproduction part completed, right? Please let me know. That chapter, theory portion of this chapter has been completed. Okay, okay. So only question answer part is left. So let me start the next chapter first. After that, I will discuss all the questions. So today I will discuss about the practical part. So what is the heading? First you have to write down the aim. Everyone, write it down in your copy. Okay, I will tell all the topics or all the headings and all the points. You have to write it down in your copy. So first, write it down. That is aim. So aim is that studying of A, binary fission in amoeba, and B, budding in yeast and hydra with the help of prepared slides. Okay, with the help of prepared slides. So that is the aim. So as you can remember that, I will not tell, you will tell me that binary fission and budding is what type of reproduction? They will come under asexual type of reproduction. Okay, so that is the aim, and you know we have read what is asexual reproduction, what is binary fission, what is budding, all we know. Okay, now tell me what is budding first. What is budding? First revise that part and after that I will tell the practical part. What is budding? Fast. Very easy question. Why you are taking too much of time? Formation of buds from the parent body. And after that, what will happen? You have to mention that part. Just bud will form, and after that, from the bud, a small offspring will grow, and when it will get mature, Srijan, don't write a small offspring. Just write down a small outgrowth. Okay, don't use the term offspring here. Just try to write a small outgrowth or a small bud. Clear? Very good. So you can remember that what is budding. Now what is binary fission? What is binary fission? Tell me. and body. Srijan, write down just like that. Don't use the term separate space. Please, the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Okay. And okay. So when the body of the organism will be divided into two, and that is called as binucleus. So you know the meaning of this term as I have explained all this term. So today, I hope all of you have written the M part. Next heading is materials required. So next heading is materials required. Okay, so under that materials required, what will be required? First, we need a compound microscope because we have to perform the practical. That means we have to see that binary fission and budding with the help of that prepared slide through the compound microscope. So, first required material is compound microscope. Second one is, second what we need, that permanent slides of binary fission, permanent slides of binary fission in amoeba. Okay, permanent slides of binary fission and amoeba and budding in yeast and hydra, and budding in yeast and hydra. Okay, so second required material is permanent slides of these two. Okay, and third one is a small piece of cotton cloth. Third one is a small piece of cotton cloth. Can you tell me why a small piece of cotton cloth is required for this practical? Any guess? I have written that for this practical we need three materials. First one is a compound microscope. Second one is permanent slides of binary fission in amoeba and budding in yeast and hydra. And third, I have written a small piece of cotton cloth. Why a small piece of cotton cloth is required? Okay, someone is writing. We have taken permanent slide to clean the slides. Yes, one we can see that to clean the slide, and another important part is to clean the lens of the microscope. Okay, so we have to see through the microscope. So if any fungus or anything is on the lens, so we have to clean it first. We have to clean the microscope with a cotton cloth, and we can't use anything except cotton material to clean the compound microscope because it is a very delicate part. Okay, lens part is very delicate. So for cleaning part we need the a small piece of cotton cloth. You can write it down in the bracket to clean the lens of microscope. So after that in the bracket you can write it down. Okay, so next part is procedure. points. Okay, I will not write it down on the board. Just listen carefully and write it down in your copy. Okay, and if you face any problem, you can ask me. So under that procedure, first heading is binary fission in amoeba, and under that just write point number one. So first write down, take the permanent slides of amoeba. Take the permanent slide of amoeba. I am repeating, take the permanent slide of amoeba. Point number two, clean the slide, clean the slide, comma, lens, L-E-N-S. Spelling of lens is L-E-N-S. Clean the slide and lens, comma, mirror of compound microscope, mirror of compound microscope with clean cotton cloth, with clean cotton cloth. So I am repeating the point number two, that clean the slide and the clean the slide and lens, comma, mirror of compound microscope with clean cotton cloth. This is point number two. Next, point number three. Put the slide on the stage of the compound microscope. Put the slide. Point number three. Put the slide on the stage of the compound microscope. I am repeating point number three. Put the slide on the stage of the compound microscope. Next, point number four. Adjust the mirror of the microscope. Adjust the mirror of the microscope. Adjust the mirror of the microscope so that maximum light is reflected from the mirror on the slide, so that maximum light is reflected from the mirror, so that maximum light is reflected from the mirror on the slide. So that is comes under point number four. Next, point number five. First, focus the slide under low power of microscope. First, focus the slide under low power of microscope. First, focus the slide under low power of microscope and observe it. And observe it. Next, point number six, then change the focus to high power very carefully. Then change the focus to high power very carefully. Then change the focus to high power very carefully. Next, point number seven. Observe the division of nucleus and cytoplasm. Observe the division of nucleus and cytoplasm. Next, point number seven. Observe the division of nucleus and cytoplasm. Next, point number eight. Draw the diagrams. Draw the diagrams showing binary fission in amoeba. Next, draw the diagrams showing binary fission in amoeba. Next, draw the diagram showing binary fission in amoeba. Next, heading budding in yeast and hydra. Next, heading under the procedure budding in yeast and hydra. Which one? Repeat point number 7. Okay, observe the division of nucleus and cytoplasm. Observe the division of nucleus and cytoplasm. That is point number 7. And point number 8 is draw the diagram showing binary fission in amoeba. Completed everyone? Any problem? Okay, so come to the next point, just next heading, that is B, budding in yeast and hydra. Just write it down, budding in yeast and hydra. Ma'am, how do we know that the amoeba is to divide itself? Means, I'm not getting your point, Srijan. That in the slide, that division portion is there. You can see that the division of the amoeba is taking place. It is present in that permanent slide, which can be seen under that microscope. You will not be able to, so how we know the time, ma'am? You will not be able to know the time from the slide because we are taking the permanent slide. As you can see that in your syllabus only it has been mentioned that permanent slide. So you no need to see the amoeba when it is dividing. Okay, you have to see the portion or the part or what will be formed after the division. That part you have to see. Clear? Okay. So, then if you want to see that one, then you have to see the live amoeba. Then you have to wait for that when it will divide. Okay. And this portion, the live amoeba from that water, you can see. I can show you whenever you will be in the most probably class 12. I will show you. Okay. But now in your practical only, the permanent slides are present. Now, next heading is budding in yeast and hydra. So, write down the first point, that take the permanent slide of budding in yeast and hydra. Take the permanent slide of budding in yeast and hydra. Take the permanent slides of budding in yeast and hydra. Next, point number 2, place the slide on the stage of the compound microscope. Point number 2, place the slide on the stage of the compound microscope. Point number 2, place the slide on the stage of compound microscope. Then, point number 3, adjust the mirror of microscope. Adjust the mirror of microscope so that maximum light is reflected on the slide. So that maximum light is reflected on the slide. Adjust the mirror of microscope so that maximum light is reflected on the slide. This point number 3. Next, point number 4, focus the slide under low power, focus the slide under low power, focus the slide under low power and then under high power. And then under high power. Focus the slide under low power and then under high power. That is point number 4. Next, point number 5. Observe it carefully and draw the diagrams showing budding in yeast and hydra Completed everyone? Okay, so today we have written up to that procedure part, the observation and result and precaution part I will discuss in my next class. Okay, so after the completion of that writing, just you have to write it down in your practical copy. So today we have completed up to the procedure part. So any question from this one, next day picture I will draw in the next day, because that will come under the observation. Under the procedure we will not write the picture, under the observation we will write. Okay, so any question? Okay, so thank you everyone and bye bye.